ओम सदाशिव समारंभाम शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपराम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतम करुणामयम नमामि चिन्मयम देवम सद्गुरुम ब्रह्म विद्वरम गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुर्साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। व्यासाय विष्णुरूपाय व्यासरूपाय विष्णवे नमो हे ब्रह्म निधे वासिष्ठाय नमो नमः। हरि ओम। सो द टॉपिक इज अवधूत गीता। मॉडर्न नेम आल्सो यू हैव टू गिव। अवधूत गीता ना वेरी ट्रेडिशनल नेम। व्हाट इज दिस अवधूत गीता? 5 days। व्हाट इज दैट? भगवद गीता आई हर्ड। व्हाट इज अवधूत गीता? द ट्रेडिशनल नेम इज अवधूत गीता। The modern name, learn to learn. So we should learn how to learn. See our Sanatana Dharma, our scriptures. How to learn also, we have to learn. So that thing we are going to learn from this Avadhuta Gita. This shloka from Avadhuta Gita, the part of Avadhuta Gita you find in 11th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam. The Mukti Skanda, 11th canto. But the second canto, you find some reference. The second skanda, you find reference. Who is this Avadhuta? So Avadhuta means the roaming saint, the wandering saint. And whomever he meets, he just gives the message, just moves. The Avadhuta. Avadhuta Sadhu. Exactly who is this Avadhuta? You have to go to second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Second canto of Bhagavatam says that Atrehe Apatyam, Atri Maharishi did tapas and he just worshipped Lord Narayana. Narayana himself appeared. He says that Datto Maya Ahameti Yad Bhagavan Sadattaha. Dattatreya's Avadhuta Gita. I hope we can read this Devanagari. It's okay. If you do not know, just listen. Paravalan. Bhagavan appeared in front of Atri Maharishi. Atri is Atri Maharishi. I'll. 1 minute. Yeah. This is Atri Maharishi. Atri. Bhagavan himself, Dattaha, Maya Ahamiti. Bhagavan says, I have given myself to you, O Atri Rishi. Because you have done such kind of penance. Very much pleased. Bhagavan himself is given to Atri Maharishi. Dattaha. Yad Bhagavan. Therefore, he is called Datta. Datta. Danam, so we say Danam. Danam Datta. So Bhagavan has done Danam himself to Atri. Therefore, he is called Datta. And he is Atri's Maharishi. He has become Atri Maharishi's son. He has become Datta Atreya. Atreya. You getting it? Datta Atreya. Therefore, he is called Datta Atreya. And this Datta Atreya only Yadu. So he taught Yadu and Haihaya, the Kartavirya Arjuna. He blessed Kartavirya Arjuna with 1,000 hands. The Kartavirya Arjuna, one who took the Ravana and put the Ravana in his jail. So Ravana has got nice background. Dattatreya only blessed Kartavirya Arjuna and he blessed Yaduraja. Okay. So all of you can open your camera. Why you are hiding behind the camera? Many of you in the main screen. Right? Are you eating or sleeping? Now itself, after 5 minutes, I didn't start now class. So I can see your face, whether we are reacting or getting something. It's online. So you can, I will not ask any question. Don't worry. I will not ask any question. All right. So this Dattatreya is none other than, this Avadhuta is none other than Dattatreya, son of Maharishi Datta. The name of Dattatreya, now you understood. He has become son of Atreya, so he's become, he has given himself to Atri Rishi, so Dattatreya. See, this is the beauty of Sanskrit. You get the meaning of each and every word, and the translation is given. You don't worry. If you start reading the translation, it will take more time. That anyway, I explained. This Dattatreya taught this Bhagavad Gita, like Bhagavad Gita, to Yadu Maharaj. Yadu is king. The great saint taught this Gita to Yadu Maharaj. This has become Avadhut Gita. Instead of telling this Dattatreya Gita, it's Avadhut Gita. Now, Bhagavan Vedavyasa has written 18 Puranas. 18. We don't have time to read all those things. At least names we can. All the 18 Puranas. The last Purana he has written is Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam. This is very, very popular shloka. It has Bhagavan Krishna's life history. At the end part of Krishna's life, you find the Avadhuta Gita. So, in this Bhagavatam, you have 12 cantos. This is very, very popular. The small information I'm giving, then we'll get into the topic. 12 cantos. You call it skandhas. Skandhas. The 11th canto has got Avadhuta Gita. 11th canto is called Mukti Skandam. Nirodha is the 10th canto, Bhagavan Krishna's life. You can find elaborately in this 10th canto, Nirodha. The 11th canto, Mukti Skandam, here only you find Avadhuta Gita. Okay? I hope you are following. Okay, then all audio, everything is okay. You will see. So the cinema effect also will bring you as usual. This is the cinema effect, okay? All right. Not getting bored, right? The 12 cantos. 18 Puranas, the last Purana, he has written Bhagavatam. In that Bhagavatam, 12 cantos. Arjuna, Krishna had two very nice friends. Nice friends. And one more friend also. Three friends. Just to leave a last friend. Kuchela. Arjuna, Uddhava and Kuchela. Three friends he had. He did not teach anything. Kuchela. Kuchela, some or that. Puffed rice, he ate, that's all. No teaching for Kuchela. So Krishna taught Arjuna and Uddhava, two people, great friends. Whenever we have friends, if they have some problem or if they need of some message, you have to give them this kind of message. Krishna gave message to Arjuna, message to Uddhava. Anyway, the two things are two messages, very, very the great messages for our life. What is the difference between the message is given to Arjuna, message is given to Uddhava? The message he has given to Arjuna is called Bhagavad Gita. Very, very popular. We are living. So without Bhagavad Gita, there is no life for us. So Bhagavad Gita has become very in a deep connection in our life. Bhagavad Gita, 18 chapters. In Bhagavad Gita, he taught Karma Yoga. Karma Yoga. For Uddhava, he has given the Gita. This is called Uddhava Gita. For Arjuna, whatever he has given, Bhagavad Gita. For Uddhava, whatever he has given, it has become Uddhava Gita. The difference between Arjuna's and Uddhava's Gita, for Arjuna, he has given Karma Yoga. You have to do Karma Yoga. You cannot escape from the battlefield. For Uddhava, he told, hey, don't do all this karma. You go to Himalayas, do tapas, get away from the samsara. For Uddhava, he has given sannyasa. Luckily, Arjuna was not there. When he was teaching sannyasa to Uddhava, Arjuna was not there. Otherwise, Arjuna would have asked, Adepri, how you are teaching sannyasa to him and karma to me? You are giving, what do you say there? This kind of food to me and you are giving idli to me and dosa to him? You are so partial, yeah. Krishna, you don't like me? You give me food which is very hard to eat. And you give very nice food to that fellow. I am asking that kind of food you are giving to that fellow. What is this? You are partial. Arjuna, Krishna has given Bhagavad Gita before itself. At the end of his life only has given sannyasa to Uddhava. The interesting part. Why Krishna had this kind of partiality? If two students were there in the school, they would have asked, you are very partial, sir. I know. You teach this kind of thing, very tough subject to me, an easy subject to him. I know you, Arjuna. Sir, this is not giving food to one person, this kind of food, other person, that kind of, this is like doctor who is treating two kinds of patients. Arjuna, you are very serious person, you go to hospital, operation to be done. Karma yoga, go to hospital, admit. Sir, I told just stomach ache, go, admit. Get admitted. And Uddhava is very clear, now he has a very slight headache, just red color tablet or white color tablet is okay. Already very, what that, is refined personality, is capable to get sannyas and go to Himalayas. Same doctor is treating different patients, a different approach. So this stand is taken by our Krishna. So Krishna had this kind of message to Uddhava and this kind of message to Arjuna. So our Gurudev has taken Bhagavad Gita for us, not Uddhava Gita. Why? So much of karma vasana. Yo-yo. More than 30, 40 years I am working in this field. 40, 50 years I am working. And still the ego is not going. Still we are asking. You didn't call me first. Therefore I will not come for this program. Oh. Sir, you are senior most. Without calling, you have to appear and you have to bless the program and you have to guide us. I cannot. Go. Sir, you achieved so many things. So you are very popular. You have seen so much of money, position, power, everything you have seen. What is there? So many years. After so many years, it's very difficult to drop the expectation and ego. Our Gurudev brought for you Bhagavad Gita's. Why operation already done? One more operation will go. Do one more operation. Why? So much of karma vasana. So Gurudev brought Bhagavad Gita for us. Why? You are living not in the garden kind of thing. Now you are living, you are not living a garden kind of the place where you are living. So you are living battlefield. For battlefield, you have to take your sword, bow and arrow, work or fight with the enemies. So many enemies. For you, Bhagavad Gita is best. Clean yourself through Bhagavad Gita Karma Yoga and come to Buddha Gita, learn sannyasa, get away from the samsara. These are steps. I hope you got the point. Are you okay? No reaction. You just keep on telling. We are hearing. Are you hearing? Okay, le? Sorry.
Yes.
So this is the difference between Bhagavad Gita and Uddhava Gita. And one very nice thing here. Uddhava Gita has got the parts. So many sections in Uddhava Gita you see. The first part of Uddhava Gita is Avadhuta Gita. So much of message he has given to Uddhava. So all put together is called Uddhava Gita. The part of Uddhava Gita is Avadhuta Gita. Another part of Uddhava Gita, Bhikshu Gita. Krishna had this. Krishna had in his mind, but he never told Arjuna, I know one Bhikshu. He also sang one song, this is called Bhikshu Gita. He never told Bhikshu because Arjuna is already ready to become Bhikshu. In Kurukshetra war, Bhikshu Gita. So he told Bhikshu Gita also, expound Bhikshu Gita also to our Uddhava. And third Gita is Hamsa Gita. And one more Gita, Aila Gita is there. You don't want that kind of Gita. Because the person lived with Urvasi and he got detachment and went away. No need. So this is very nice Gitas. Three Gitas. Avadhuta Gita, Bhikshu Gita and Hamsa Gita. All three Gitas put together is called Uddhava Gita. There are three sections. So much he spoke to Uddhava. So our lesson this 5 days is Uddhava Gita. So we'll take Uddhava Gita and Avadhuta Gita and we'll see what he told to our Uddhava. The Dattatreya is called Avadhuta, I told. The Avadhuta is none other than Dattatreya, the Vishnu Avatar, the great teacher. Now, in life, somebody is teaching us. from the childhood. The teaching part, someone should be there and they have to teach us. Then we come to know about this kind of thing. Then the teaching is one part of life. First teach. You teach, they will receive. Or somebody should teach and we will receive teaching. Next comes facilitating. Facilitate, you just facilitate, they learn. I'm not teaching, just facilitating. If I facilitate, the child can learn. Second part. Third part comes the learning all. No need to have any facilitation. No, don't teach me, okay? It's irritating. Yeah. Every now and then sitting and teaching. I don't like teacher. The teaching part. Facilitation, no. Now what about learning? I will learn myself. This is what that, just to teach them. When you teach, they will fall. Yeah. How to walk, how to swim, teach them. The teaching is very difficult. So even if you teach, the mind will not be there, mind will not be there to receive whatever you teach. Teaching is a little difficult. First, just make some facilitation, the child can use the facilities and can pick up. Then afterwards, child says, hey, no facilities needed, no need of any facilities, no need of teaching, now I learned. The child itself starts. Oh, in the beginning, you feed the child. The difference between teaching, facilitating, in the beginning, the mother used to take food and used to give to the child. In a parupu sadam. I will say in English, in a dull food. I don't know how to translate. Food. So the beginning period of the child, 3-4 years, is take the food. As much as possible, you are trying to feed. The same percentage of the effort, the child also runs away from your food because the child doesn't like your food. Yeah. How my mother cooks. Child also, you are also running. So both of you are coming into one point, then somehow you fed the child. It goes inside. It is difficult, teaching difficult. Your receiver also should be there. Teacher should be there, receiver should be there. If teacher is not good, receiver is good, there also teaching will not happen. The receiver is very good, teacher is not good. Some places, the receiver is not good, teacher is very good. Teaching will not happen. It is difficult. Facilitation, just you make all, first you teach, feed the child. Second facilitation, you make all the dishes in the kitchen, close everything, and keep all the dishes on the plate, in the dining table. You just go away. The children will come and they will swallow everything. That is facilitation. You are making facilitation. They know how to eat it. All dabbas will be gali. No leftover. Facilitation. Learning. And then, I know how to cook. Just you get out, I go. I will do my thing, then I will swallow. Now here, in this avadhuta, what we are going to see, we are not going to, the teaching style, we are not going to facilitation, doing or somebody is going to facilitate us. We are going to learn how to learn. That is another part in avadhuta Gita. The learning, how to learn, that we are going to learn in this avadhuta Gita. Give up. Actually, all the teachers and all the students, they should know this part, learning process, how to learn. The learning, you have to make effort. The teaching and the facilitation, the teacher has to make effort. Teacher should do homework. Teacher should prepare a chart, this and that, the teacher should bring. A facilitation also, she has to bring all the thing. The teacher learning, no need of teacher, I myself get up and try to learn and search the books in the libraries and go get the reference, this and that, meet people going many places. I collect all the information, then I come to understand. This is called learning. All the schools and universities should create the children. You have to learn yourself. You yourself should learn in your life. Don't depend on anything. If you depend, always you depend on some teacher. The beginning level you can depend and get. After some day, how to learn. This learning, we are going to see in this avadhuta Gita. A very nice part. There is no dependency. The beginning you need to have some support. Afterwards, just take all the supports, then you walk in the path of liberation. ஓகேவா? யா நவ் சோ தி டீச்சிங்ல வந்து we learn so many things from our own reflections. First thing, if we reflect, we can learn on the reflection. The first Gurudev says, the old age comes by passage of time, the knowledge maturity comes by deep reflection. Old age, so I become so old. Excuse me, sir, time only took you. You know, I become old. Don't worry, time is there. The flow of time will take your ages. That will come very automatically. Old age comes with passage of time. Maturity comes by deep reflection. Maturity and knowledge comes with deep reflection. Reflecting on a particular subject will give great insights. So this is one thing. And second, directed advice from others. We learn so many things from advice. They advise us. From the childhood, so many people advised. So direct advice will make us a nice person. Another thing, indirect message from others. Somebody is giving message to somebody, we hear, hey, this is my message. It's going from one person to other person. I got, okay, this is for me. So when we are very alert, at that time, somebody is teaching somebody, oh, this message is for me. We learned in that way also. The direct advice or indirect message, we will catch that kind of mess. The fourth one, from others' mistake. If somebody is doing mistake, we will go and we will say, oh, you, from this mistake I understood, I should not do this kind of. When you drive the car, when you go on the road, when you walk, somebody, oh, you, this kind of mistake we should not do. Learning from others' mistake. They invested their time, their effort and their life. From their investment, we come to understand this is called or this kind of learning. It's also so many methods we learn. The fourth one, from our own mistake. Others' mistakes, our own mistake. And many people, they do mistake, keep on doing mistake after mistake, no learning. And they say, what kind of experience I have in my life? Sir, you had experience. What kind of learning you had from your mistakes? That is more important. The people used to say, I worked in this company 30 years experience, 20 years experience. Sir, experience will come because you are there in the company. You don't find other than nice company, other than this. So you are there. So you should not do this kind of number. So don't beat your drums. You are there 20, 25 years. What kind of learning you got? That is more important. Simply existing in the company 20 years or 30 years, they say very proudly, this, oh, 20 years. Okay. In 20 years, how much you learned? That is more important. Existing in the company for 10, 20 years is not that thing. So I have experience means what? I had experience with, from your experience, what kind of learning you got? Because we are passing through so many incidents. From the so many incidents, we sit and analyze and we get this kind of learning. Then maturity comes, then you become experienced person. After retirement, you can become advisor to another company. Otherwise, simply I worked for this company 20 years, I become advisor. No. So the person did not use this intellect and the reflecting capacity. We experience. From the experience, you learn and you become advisor and you become very knowledgeable person. The person with wisdom. This is more important. So this is how we learn in our life. Okay? Learn. When we learn, we should not feel very bad. So from our own mistake, whenever we do some mistake, we feel very bad. No, don't worry. No need to worry about the experience. We have to learn from the experience. When a scripture says that, don't think about the past. Well, we will ask question. Don't think about the past. Forget the past. Now, forgetting past is impossible. So that statement is wrong actually. When we read scriptures, forget your past. How can you forget the past? That is not possible. So what they mean by forgetting the past, don't worry about the mistakes happened in the past. And when we think the past, we should not worry. When we think the past, we should learn from the past. That is what they meant. I hope you understood. Okay. So this is the learning methods in our life. Now we'll get into the subject. Now, Krishna. Lord Krishna started. So he has to go from this world. Now avatar is over. Avatar is over. So for what purpose he has, or the, he arrived and he finished the job and he has to go back. So he went to forest, sat under that Ashwatha Vriksha. So at that time Uddhava came. It's the last moment then Krishna leaves. Uddhava came. So Uddhava is the last person who met Krishna when Krishna left the world. Uddhava went and Uddhava asked, "Oh Lord, I think that you are, this is the time you are going to Vaikuntha Loka. Please take me also to Vaikuntha Loka. I don't want to live here without your presence." What Uddhava told. Krishna told, no, this time I'm going alone. Last time in Rama Avatara, I took everybody and I took in the Sarayu River. We went all to Vaikuntha Loka. And this avatar, I'm going to drop everyone. And I'm going alone. So Uddhava, you cannot come with me. So you go to Himalayas, do tapas and come from there to my place. This is your way is different. Go. And Uddhava says, no, I want to spend little time with you. Because whenever we meet this kind of our beloved people, we don't want to leave them. So we will extend the time by asking some question. Even the phone also. If you like someone, you like someone, but they don't like it. How are you? Oh, all okay, va? Oh, it's not unnecessary question they ask. But you, okay, all okay. They don't give time, space to say, are you? Otherwise, would have told that, are you? No. Keep on extending the call. In the same way, Uddhava also kept extending his time. He didn't want to leave Krishna. Oh, he asked a few questions. That few questions became, Uddhava Gita. So there is this conversation between Uddhava and Krishna. At that time, Krishna told so many Gitas. I told you the Uddhava Gita, Avadhuta Gita, Hamsa Gita and Bhikshu Gita, all the Gitas he told. This is the place where they had nice conversation. The last part of Krishna's life. He Sri Bhagavan watch. He asked Bhagavan, Na vastavyam toya eva ihe maya tekte mahital. He says that, Arjuna Uddhava, when I leave this world, you don't please live here. You also go to Himalayas and do tapas, come to my place. Janaha adharma ruchihi, he says very nice. All the people will have the taste for adharma hereafter. The moment I leave this world, that moment the Kali will appear on this earth and they will have taste for adharma. You can say why people are doing like this. Janaha adharma ruchihi. See, very nice. Janaha adharma ruchihi badra bhavishyati kalau yuge. The Kali Yuga. This Kali Yuga, they will have more taste for adharma, Krishna says. No statement is given. You cannot ask hereafter why people are behaving like this. And he heard, Janaha adharma ruchihi badra bhavishyati kalau yuge. Krishna told there itself. But again and again, you should not ask why people are behaving. I do not know. Why people are behaving? Oh, I do not know. Excuse me. Krishna told, this is Kali Yuga. They will behave like this only. I didn't do anything. Yes, even though you don't do anything, they will do like this only. Why? Adharma ruchihi. This is the reason. So hereafter, we should not ask question. Krishna told Uddhava, Uddhava, Kali Yuga, Jana, all the people will be taste. They will have taste for adharma. Naturally, it comes. That is the dharma of Kali. Tomtu sarvam parityajya. He says that. Tomtu sarvam parityajya. He never told this word to Arjuna. Arjuna, he was about to paritejja everything. No, hold everything. Mamanasmara idyacha, go work in the field. Sir, please allow me to go to forest. No, go back, go to the battlefield. For you, battlefield is a place where you can clean yourself. Uddhava, you are already clean. Go to Himalayas. Paritejja, sannyasa. Sneham swajana bandushu. Sneham means the attachment with your own people. So with the own people, just give up everything. Mai avesha mana samyak samadriki vicharasvagam. Keep your mind on me and see all the Samadarshana, have Samadarshana and move. Very nice message. Drop your attachment, keep your mind on me, and you start moving. This is what Krishna told. Go to Himalayas. He goes to Badrikashram there. Now he's ready to move. Yatidam manasa vacha chakshubhyam shravanadabhihi. Whatever you see through your mind, your sense organs and your buddhi, all this nashvaram grihamanam cha. All everything is impermanent and perishable. Whatever you see and whatever you feel in this world, oh Uddhava, you understand everything is perishable. Nashvaram grihyamanam cha vidhi maya manomayam. You understand everything is projection of the maya. Okay, the Vedantic idea he brought. Everything is impermanent and nashvaram. Nashvaram means perishable and maya manovar. Understand this. Oh, Uddhava, understand. Know this world grasped by the mind, speech and eyes and ears and other senses to be unsustainable and transitory. Nashvara means what that? Impermanent and perishable. Just live. This is nothing but the Maya's roop, Maya roop, Maya Maya. And get ready for sannyasa. And Sri Shuka Uvacha. Bhagavan Sukha Brahma Rishi only explains his Bhagavatam to Parikshit. That's why the Shuka Uvacha comes. Sukadeva says to Parikshit, hey Parikshit, this is the conversation between Uddhava and Krishna. You should not ask who is this Sukadeva. Then I have to go back, tell all the stories of Srimad Bhagavatam. So this is not, we are not going to see all the stories. This is one part of Bhagavatam, therefore the Sukha comes. Iti adishtaha bhagavata mahabhagavatam nirpa. When Uddhava was told by Lord Krishna, Uddhava pranipatya aha. Krishna told, drop everything, move from this world and keep your mind on me. Finish. Everything is maya. Uddhava, get out. Message is over. Vedanta is over. Uddhava, now Kali Yuga is coming. People will have taste for Kali Yuga. And then janaha adharma ruchi bhavishyati kalo yugo, he told. Okay, number one. Number two, drop everything. Tumta sarvam parityajya sneham swajana bandushu. Drop everything. And vicharaswagam samadrike. I have the samadrishti, get out. Okay, bye. The message is what? 2-3 shlokas, all the message, whatever he wants to give, he has given everything. Uddhava, he wants to extend the time. Uddhava pranipatyahu tatva jignyasu achyutam. Tatva jignyasu. The student of Vedanta, Achyutam, he asked Lord Krishna few questions. He asked a few questions. Instead of 2-3 minutes meeting, it has become a 3 hours meeting. Nice time to spend with Krishna. He asked. Now he says there, Uddhava vacha, yogesha yoga vinyasa yogatma yoga sambhava. Praising the Lord. Hey Krishna, nishrayasayame proktaha tyaga sannyasa lakshana. You told give up everything and get out from this world. Simple, two slokas before only told. You told, tomta sarvam parityajya sneham swajana bandushu. You heard that just 2-3 slokas back. Tyagaha sannyasa lakshanaha. Tyagam, so giving up everything is not very easy. So whatever we say, in our on behalf of us, he asked the question. It's very difficult to give up the anything. First of the cell phone. The attachment of the cell phone. Yappa. Without cell phone. Cell phone is 6th prana for the person now. Vedanta says 5 pranas. Prana, apana, udana, vyana, samana and cell phone. 6th prana is outside. If I leave the cell phone, oh, my prana is gone. See the condition of our pranic state, self attachment. Attachment in the my house, attachment with my house, car, relatives. First of all, I do not know where all I have attachment. First, we have to understand, then slowly I have to cut. When we cut this attachment, we feel insecure. We have to cut and get all the, what that, detachment from everything. He says, very, very difficult. He says, attachment, detachment is very difficult. Dropping the things are very, very difficult. This is the human task. We have come here to live in this world, cut everything and get ready for liberation. The highest task for human life is Asanga Shastrena Dridena Chitva. Yeah, Krishna says in 15th chapter, Asanga Shastrena. Asanga, with the detachment, the sword of detachment, you cut all the attachment. More than 10, 15 years I'm hearing this. But I don't know when will I take the sword to cut all the attachment. Still it is there. My sword is lying down in my puja room. One day I will take and cut all the things. This is everyday process, you keep on cutting. This is very, very difficult to get sannyasa. Uddhava told, very difficult. You say something about this, okay? Sannyasa tyaga sannyasa nishreyasaya me proktaha. So whatever you told about sannyasa is very difficult. Tyagohyam dushkaraha. Tyagohyam dushkaraha bhuman kamanam vishayatma vihi. The person who is attached with sense objects and sense organs, vishayatma kamanam, vishayatma vihi, is very much attachment for him. Sutaram tai sarvatma na abhaktaihi time matihi. Bhakta will get. So devotion. The person who has got bhakti towards you, for him, dropping the things is very easy. But vishayatma, kamanam, they have desire in their heart. They are very much attachment to the objects outside. For them, tyagoyam dushkaraha. It's very, very difficult to give up. Exactly. Very practically he speaks. Sir, you are devotee, you can drop. In our case, I am not devotee. Every day I am increasing my attachment to the things. How can I drop? Nice question. Yes. So our case is like the monkey or that keeps his hand inside this bottle to get fruit. Oh, the monkey, he catches the fruit inside the bottle. If you catch the fruit, with the fruit it is very difficult to get out. If you drop the fruit, then your hands will come. How the monkey is suffering the same way in our life also? Yes. The human monkey, that's a difference. So how the monkey, hey, you drop this banana, your hands will come out. No. I will suffer like anything. I will take the fruit, but fruit is not coming with me, but I will suffer. You see, this is mental suffering. I'm not saying physically, we are suffering, mental suffering. So this kind of mental suffering with one object, the same kind of mental suffering with so many objects. You see our mind condition. Therefore, we are not getting peace in life. Even though we have everything. We have everything, so much of money, dollars and what that house, all the relatives, everything we have. I do not know, I'm not getting happiness. The happiness is not with the objects outside. If you know how to keep your mind very happy, then you are happy. Happiness comes by giving up things and keep your mind always free. Very interesting. To understand this part is very, very difficult actually. So we think that when I get everything, I will be happy. Getting everything, keeping everything will not become happy. So happiness belongs to mind, not to the things. In the beginning, we think that when I get everything, I'll be happy. So after that, we got everything. Now we understand, even though I have everything, I'm not happy. Then where is this happiness? Somewhere in the heart. This is okay. Vishayatma bihi, it's very difficult to dushkara. Tyagohim dushkara. He says that tyaga is dushkara only. He's not telling this is very easy to drop. Oh, drop ego. Oh, okay, I'll drop now. Nobody will say it. It's very, very difficult to drop. He accepts. Our Uddhava accept. Sir, it's very difficult, sir. Yeah, you say something. Sri Bhagavan Uvacha. And Bhagavan starts telling. Yes, okay. It's very difficult, but you have to make some effort to. Because it's very difficult, I'm not able to do this project. You cannot tell. So you make some effort. Make some effort. Arjuna also says in 6th chapter, very difficult to control the mind, sit in the meditation. Arjuna says, and Krishna explains, yes, I will agree. I agree with your idea, Arjuna. അസംശയം മഹാബാഹോ മനോ ദുർനിഗ്രഹം ചലം. അഭ്യാസ എന്നത് കൗന്തേയെ വൈരാഗ്യർച്ച ഗൃഹ്യത്തെ. ഇഫ് യു ആർ ഇഫ് യു പ്രാക്ടീസ് ദ ഡിറ്റാച്ച്മെന്റ് ഇറ്റ്സ് പോസിബിൾ. പോസിബിലിറ്റീസ് ആർ ദേർ, ബട്ട് യു ഹാവ് ടു മേക്ക് എഫേർട്ട്. ഭഗവാൻ വാച്ച് ഏക ദ്വി ത്രീ ചതുഷ്പാദ, സോ മെനി ലെഗ്സ്, ഏകപാദ ദ്വിപാദ ത്രിപാദ ചതുഷ്പാദ, സോ മെനി പാദസ്. ദ ക്രിയേച്ചേഴ്സ് ഹാസ് ബിൻ ക്രിയേറ്റഡ്. ബഹുപദാഹ തഥാ അപദ, ദേർ ഇസ് നോ ലെഗ്സ്. The creatures with no legs and so many legs like cockroach and two legs like us and four legs like animal. So many legs I created among them. Bhakyaha santi pura srishtaha tasame paurushi priya. I have created so many creatures with so many legs, but I like human beings so much. For me, the very, or that the popular thing are very close, how to say, very dear to me is a human being. The human being I created very dear to me. Why? In that human form only the man can atrama margayanti. In this human form only the man can search for me. The searching. The man can become seeker in the human being. So Lord Krishna likes those who seek him, seeker. Tatapadam tatpari margitavyam. He says that having given up the attachment of the world, then you have to search for the truth. Only human being can search for the truth, not other thing, other living beings. Buddha, he had three scenes he had. In the old age, death and the disease. Three things he saw, dropped everything, searching for the truth. Search. 5-6 years he searched very severely and he got enlightened. അത്രമാം മാർഗയന്തി യുക്തഃ ഹേതുഭിഃ ഈശ്വരം. ബൈ ലോജിക്, ലോജിക് ആൻഡ് ആസ്കിംഗ് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ, ഇൻഫറൻസ്, ദേ ഫൈൻഡ് മീ ഇൻ ദ ഹ്യൂമൻ ബർത്ത്. ഗൃഹ്യമാനൈഃ ഗുണൈഃ ലിംഗൈഃ അഗ്രാഹ്യം അനുമാനതഃ. ദേ യൂസ് ലോജിക് ആൻഡ് ഇൻഫറൻസ്, ദേ ഫൈൻഡ് മീ. ദറ്റ് മീൻസ് യു ആർ യൂസിംഗ് ദ വേദാന്തിക ഐഡിയാസ് ടു ഫൈൻഡ് ഹിം. ദിസ് വാട് ഹി മീൻസ് ഹിയർ, നാട് കൃഷ്ണ. അത്രാപി ഉദാഹരണത്തി ഇമം ഇതിഹാസം. ഐ വിൽ ടെൽ യു വൺ തിങ് ഹാപ്പൻഡ് വൺസ് അപ്പോൺ എ ടൈം. ഐ വിൽ ടെൽ യു ദറ്റ് പുരാണ. ഇതിഹാസം പുരാണ മീൻസ് ഐ എം ഗോയിങ് ടു ടെൽ യു ദ സ്റ്റോറി. ഇതിഹാസം ഇറ്റ് ഹാപ്പൻഡ് ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ്. പുരാണ മീൻസ് ദ ഏൻഷ്യന്റ് ഡേയ്സ്, കൃഷ്ണ ബിഫോർ കൃഷ്ണസ് പീരിയഡ് ഹാപ്പൻഡ് ഏൻഷ്യന്റ് ദ തിങ് ഹാപ്പൻഡ്. അവധൂതസ്യ സംവാദം യദോഹോ അമിതത്തെ. യദു ആൻഡ് അവധൂത, ടു പീപ്പിൾ ആർ ടാക്കിംഗ്. വെൻ ദേ സ്പോക്ക് in the converse, they had very nice ideas. Those ideas I am going to tell you. You getting it? This is the background. Why Krishna told this kind of thing to Uddhava? The background I explained. Now Krishna is telling, I will explain the conversation between Yadu king. So this in the Krishna's word, that parampara, the lineage, the Yadu king came. This Yadu is the son of Yayati. Yayati is son of Nagusha. In this Chandravamsa kings, Nagusha, Yayati, Yadu, in this Yadu Vamsa only Krishna came. And Krishna says, Yadu Raja had a nice conversation with Avadhuta. Avadhuta, who is this Avadhuta? Dattatreya. How do you know? Go to second canto of Bhagavatam, there it says, Avadhuta is Dattatreya. We understood that. Why his name is Dattatreya? We understood. Bhagavan himself is given to Atri Rishi. So he has become son of Atri, Dattam. Atreya, so Dattatreya. Okay, now Krishna said, Abadutam dujam kaschit charantam akutobayam kavim nirikshatarunam yaduhu paprachya dharmi yaduhu paprachya. So when Yadu went to forest, in those days kings used to go to forest to hunt. Our military people are practicing every day. Every day they have to do practice in the same way. In those days kings used to go to forest and they practice. Otherwise they will eat and they will sit in one place and they will put on weight. The enemy comes, they thought how to take sword, how to handle bow and arrow. Those days, they go to forest, hunt. They have to keep their body fit. Yadu went. When he went to forest, he met one Jnani, Sadhu Purusha. That Sadhu Purusha is Avadhuta. See, asked Kavim Tarunam, Kavim Nirikshatana, Kavim, see, he knew everything. Tarunam is a very young person. Navaduta is a very young person. We should not think only if I become 70, 80 year old, I go to a Vedanta class. Yeah, you sit, but you sleep there. 70. After 5 minutes, sound comes. You see where the sound comes. That person sitting comfortable, sofa and sleep. Sir, not 60, 70, you go to Vedanta class or hear something from the childhood, you have to hear. How to learn. That part we have to teach when they were a child. As an 80 year old, how to learn? I learned everything in what you want to tell me, tell me. 80 year old. Learned everything. What kind of the subtle ideas? Subtle ideas very difficult to impart. So you need to have a young age, Tarunam, the young man. Avadutam dujam kaschete kanchete charanda makuto vayam. He moves in the forest, very young person. And he, our Yadu Raja met him. Yadu paparacha dharma. So dharma, the righteous person Yadu, he went and did namaskar. Sir, I met so many people in my country, but in the forest you are moving alone. Akutobayam. There is no fear of any of the insects and rakshasas or lion and akutobayam, just moving in the forest very nicely. Very rare to see this kind of person. Yadu vacha. Yadu asked, sir, kutaha buddhiyam brahma nakurtu suvisharada. Yam asadhya bhavan lokam vidwan sarati balavati. You look like a child. But even though you are matured, you look like child. So this is childlike is different. Childish is childish means there is no maturity. Childlike means balavat. So it's a matured person, but you look very happy. Moving in this forest. Forest la happy. Even though we have everything, not happy. See the difference. What we have? Everything, power, position, money, popularity, everything. Are you happy? No. Only happiness I don't have. Except happiness, I have everything in my life. Where are you living? Developed country. Developed country. Are you happy to search happiness? Only I came here. Now I am suffering like anything. I do not know how to get out. Here this person is moving the forest. Not having anything. No network. No internet, nothing. Simply moving the forest, eating some fruits, drinking, I very happy. From this we can understand to be happy, no need to have anything. Different skill. How to be happy is a different skill. Whether you have it, you are not having it. Whenever we get very nice people with us, we are happy. Not nice people, I have no happiness. Whenever nice people, happiness. When they go, they are going. Sir, people will come, people will go. Things will come, things will go. You should know how to keep your mind happy always. Other skill. You are very happy, sir. See, moving the forest, this is very rare thing to see. Prayah dharmartha kameshu vivatsayam cha manavaha hetuna eva samihante. All the manushas I see in my city and the village, they are all going for dharmartha kama. They will go dharma, artha, kama only. And they will go work for ayus, yashas and sri. Sri means wealth. Yashas means popularity. And ayus means they lead something to extend their life. You will become wealthy and you will live long. Take care of your health. I have to live long. And I have to get popularity. And I have to get well, all the things they are doing there in the city, but you are in the forest. You are so happy. What is this? It's very nice to see. Jadanta, jada unmata pishachvat. You are moving like jada purusha, pishachi and unmata, like what, that mad person. But you are not mad, but you look like that. We should not think jnanis are mad people. No, they look like mad, not mad. They look like pishach, but not pishach. Vat, you look like. Moving in this forest, oh, this is very interesting to see. You are kalpa, kavihi, dakshaha, subhaga, amrita bhashana. You speak very nicely. You look like so young and you are very happy. Very, very rare to meet this kind of person. He's praising him like anything.